We just built a brand new studio in the Skyway headquarters in Copenhagen, and we already posted a little glimpse on social media, so you have an idea about what is in here. We'll now go in depth with the configurations, because of course we're using our own equipment to run it. We have a PTC Extreme in this video. We'll also look at a Colorfly at some point, Airfly Pro, and we have a Regfly Duo over here. And then we have a lot of great equipment from so many of our partnering manufacturers, so we can't wait to share all this with you. In this video, the PTC Extreme is on the bench, and we have such an amazing configuration for this one that will really blow your mind in terms of what Unisketch and Skyway controllers can do. It's really, really powerful, and it's completely custom. So this is not out of the box at all, but it will show you how far you can go if you're really dedicated to getting exactly what you want for your show. So let's look at it. We have basically four different types of image acquisition sources, cameras, that we are working with here. We have a LAN camera in the studio. This is a Sony C90 camera, which is like on the roof and a top view camera for the studio. Then we have a Panasonic PTC camera, a 4K UE150, very awesome camera. Then we have a camera on an Emotimo slider to make soft moves. And finally, we have two NewTek PTC cameras. One of them is in the studio and another one is out here. In fact, you might find some of these cameras being in a permanent installation a little funny, because why would we have a camera in the control room? But the thing is that our studio and our control room is also a showroom, along, by the way, with the showroom just next door. But having those spy cameras around will make it possible to host demonstrations and training for you guys out there through Zoom calls, for instance. So this is why we put them up in a permanent installation. On this controller, this is the basic menu. If I click LANC, I now get LANC control for my camera. If I click Panasonic, I get access to Panasonic features. But actually, there are 18 buttons which are always available no matter what camera I have selected. And that's a special approach actually, but it's really useful. So let's just get acquainted with the sources we have here. And this row of buttons are recalling presets on the Panasonic camera in the studio. So now I have a close up to the table. I now have a table view from the UE150. I'm recalling a preset here, which is for our little demo lineup here. Then we have a wide shot preset, and then I have preset 6 and 5, 5 and 6 here, which could be whatever that I want them to be. Of course, if I need to control the camera, now notice that actually when I'm controlling this one, we actually are controlling one of the NewTek PTC cameras. So having the direct access to presets needs you to think about what camera is available on my joystick. So let me just go to the Panasonic, and then I can, of course, use the joystick to just frame something here with the Panasonic camera. And then I could probably store this preset on 7 or 6. So I just do that by pressing and holding. So let's just see if we got that. Yes, we did. All right, perfect. Now, we are now looking at the Panasonic camera configuration. So let's just continue that. In other words, these were always there. And actually, as I selected Panasonic, you see that we decided to extend it to the full row. So we have access to all 12 presets that we would immediately have here without having a shift key to patch them in. But apart from that, I also have the Panasonic PTC control on the joystick, as I have now selected Panasonic here. So I can, of course, navigate and use my camera with the joystick. I also have the zoom rocker available if I want to use that to zoom in. This is another one of the great features you have with the PTC Extreme, that you have both a joystick and for your left hand, you have a zoom rocker. We can also work with the iris here, so you can see that I'm able to basically shade a little bit on my image, turn up and on, down the light, and I can also focus with the focus knob. So these are all standard features on the PTC Extreme for a Panasonic camera assigned to the knobs over here. We have autofocus, auto iris, and OSD on and off. We have some speed limitation, which is generally available for these, as you'll see, sensor gain, shutter speed, master pedestal. So we can also work with the black levels like this. All right. White balance mode. We have white balance execute here. And then we have color temperature over here. Also, we have built in access to the cropping features in the UE150. These features allow you to define some crops in the 4K image that you can take out of the camera directly. And we are working on integrating that in the workflow. But this is still work in progress, like you would expect from this kind of configuration, where we are all the time tweaking and optimizing for the production workflows we have. So that's really the reason why you want to customize, because this controller will eventually represent a window into how we run our productions at Skyhoy. So this is the wonderful consequence of being able to this tightly customize your PVC Extreme for operating these many different cameras. So that was a Panasonic camera, only the basics. Notice that we don't go into all kinds of, we haven't broken out really a lot of the features in the Panasonic camera because we don't need them. We just wanted those things that we really needed. And that's the general rule that we are going by here. So Panasonic, let's move on to the Lang camera. And actually coming back to the 18 buttons, these six and these 12 buttons here and how they are assigned to presets. I never finished that because I kind of wandered off. These are six presets for the Emotimo slider. If I press this one, the slider will start moving to the left. You can actually see it, but it's really happening slowly over here. So now we just put it in motion and it's now over a number of seconds, like 20 seconds, moving to the other end of the slider. So that's what I can do with these green buttons. Then we have some which are more cyan in the color that we chose for them. And this is three presets for NewTek camera number one and another three presets for the other one. So let's try. If I press this one, I'm now in the control room. It's right up there. And I see the wall. So we can use that if we want to demonstrate the wall of video routing and ATEM switches up there. Then if we press white, we have this view, and controller, we have this view where we are focusing on the PVC Extreme as we are now demonstrating it. So those are the three presets programmed for that guy. These three are for the studio. So this is like a wide shot. This is a table shot. And finally, we also have a shot for the Emotimo slider right here. And it needs to autofocus. Hopefully that happens right there. There we go. All right, so that was 2x3 presets there. And then we have the presets for the Panasonic, of course. Okay, so let's look at the Lang. So Lang camera doesn't have presets. And by the way, this is not a pan tilt camera. It's actually a fixed position camera, but we can zoom over Lang. This is our Ethernet Lang Link product connected to the Sony C90 camera. So it's like a consumer prosumer sort of camera. We think that it gives a nice image. And as you can see, we also put a lot of effort into combining different sorts of image acquisition cameras in the studio here so we can demonstrate control of these many different things. But Lang, let's try to zoom in. And you can see I have it on the zoom rugger right here that I can zoom with my camera in the top. And that's super, super useful to be able to do that. We can also do it on the joystick. So we mapped it both places. But obviously, if I use the joystick for working with the camera over Lang, then I am not able to, I can't expect anything from the pan and the tilt operation. So now I'm moving the joystick like this. Nothing happens, of course. But I can zoom. So that's really, really useful. This is over Lang. The Lang protocol, very, very limited. But the things that you can do over Lang, we can also map it down on a controller, of course. So, and actually there is quite a number of things we can do. So one of the things is that we can enable zebraing. So you see zebra stripes on the output here. We have a lesser degree of zebra stripes right now. I can also enable focus peaking here. So that's done. I have the ability to also bring up this view with various overlays. And I can cycle that, so you can see that I have these available on these two buttons that I can toggle these on and off. Very, very useful being able to do that. I can execute white balancing here. If I won't do it right now, but if I did, then I would also see information on the display. And then finally, if we look at the rotation of the peaking, I see those icons on the screen right here. And the focus peaking and the various levels of that is also available. Okay, so these things are really useful. Being able to sit here in the control room and get that information out allows me to work with that top view camera quite a lot. So that's really, really nice. I do have iris control of this camera as well over Lang once again. So it's just mapped down onto this button as I would expect. So that's super cool. Up here, I have recording start stop. I have power on off. And those features are also available and useful from out here. I want to start recording, and I need to start recording on the camera in there, so it's available overlaying from this controller. If we move on to the motor mode slider, we have a number of settings up here. Like I can design the ramp speed and the time to target here for preset number 2. So these are some of the things that we can adjust. We can select the preset. We have those 6 presets right here. So I could select these, and then I can adjust the settings of time to target and ramping over here. And then of course I could execute that. In this little menu, which kind of follows which camera I'm selecting, you can see this is changing along with this little menu here. On the Emotimo menu, I am able to cycle through a number of things that I can set here. I can set limits, okay? So limits means that how far to the left and right is the pan function on the Emotimo gonna go? How far up and down will it go? How far on the slider will it go? And those limits for their low and the high values can be triggered here as I'm shifting through. So here we have pan limit, then we have tilt limit, we have motor 3 limit, which is the slider, and then we're back here at pan limit once again. So, and I can clear it all. So that's very Motimo specific things that are now mapped down right here. Let's move on to NewTek. If I go to NewTek, then we do have, I think, more presets, in fact. You can see again what we had down here changing around. When I select NewTek, I have some more stuff. Actually, I want to see what happens here. So in the studio, we have more specific presets zooming in on certain devices, as you can see. And I think this is a studio camera, which has additional presets 4 to 6 that allows me to zoom in on certain features. So what was that? That was actually our top-down camera right here. And over here we have the Panasonic camera. And then this is our little rack patch place. So between these two cameras, I can also move on this one, because now the joystick will belong to one of them. So this is my control room PTC camera right up there. But this has now become a selector for changing over to the studio PTC camera. So that's like my camera selector when I'm in the NewTek menu, okay? And I'm now able to move the camera around in the studio. Okay, so I can do image flip as well. If I go to the other camera, I'm flipping that image, and we can go into the menu. We also have a number of broken out features up here, but once again, we have only chosen those that are meaningful in this context, like gain shutter speed and white balance mode, exposure mode, and so forth, and limited the whole setup to only what we would use in operation. I think this is an amazing configuration. It does take time to build something like this, but that's what you can do with Skyhawk controllers. Much of the time we show you what comes out of the box. We show you default configurations that are prepared, ready-made, that will work for you and create success for you really quickly. In this case, we show you something completely different, but that's the road you can decide to take if you really want to customize your controllers. You can go this far and have such a specific configuration. So we hope this is inspiring to you to see how we are using our own technology to enhance our productions. And if you want to learn more, we have plenty of materials online. You can follow us for news on social media, and we have a wonderful support hotline you can always write if you are stuck in a problem and need inspiration to move on. Thanks for watching, and I hope you can't wait for the next episode in this little tour of our studio.